Hakon looks at you and shrugs. Tell me, Uruk, what makes you better than the hundreds of other chieftains out here? Men whose good deeds I've heard of, no less. The only difference is I'm here before you now. Ha! Humility and confidence all in the same breath. You remind me of the village chieftain from my childhood, a good man. Then allow this good man to bring his clan inside your walls. There are other good men among these clans. It doesn't change how many Arbaran can hold or feed. Only now you see Aruga, Dagger, and 2,000 fighters approaching, the king's guards with concern. Aruga? Maynulf? I should have killed you when I had a chance. You tried, remember? Did the Thunderslayer convince you to open your gates to your people? You will never enter my gates again. I'd hoped you died in Borsgard. How is it you've come to speak for all these clans? The people you've turned your back on? Seems they need a leader they could trust. Again, how have you come to speak for them? Did you fool them like the people of that rotten town you governed? The only fool here is the outnumbered king, believing he still has a say in what happens now. Don't make us breach your walls. We'll just have to repair them once we're inside. So quiet is it between them. With that many, you might get through a wall or two, but you will die at the foot of the Black Wall. Listen to the pride in this king's voice when he speaks of killing thousands of his people. There's nothing good in any of this, but I'll take a small amount of comfort in your death. You're a petty king and no longer deserve the title. Rook, look at your people out there. Our people. They need food and clean water, not that poison in the river. They need protection. You cannot allow this king to keep us from safety after all this way. He doesn't have to. I'll find a place for the people under your banner, Rook. A place inside the walls alongside the Vaal. A place Thane men will never be allowed again. That's enough! Both of you are bickering like children instead of leaders. And you, Jaya, joining this king after all we did to keep your people alive. Traitor! Hakon growls and flexes his whip on his hands. All parties look angry and tense, and then they look at you. Yuga's right. Too many will die out here for so few inside. You see, Maynulf? He knows how the game works. Now, the former governor's eyes look full of mischief. Uruga blows into a war horn, sending out one shrill note. You look back and see his force either charging the wall or turning on Vaal. Your clan is divided, humans calling off against Vaal, their former allies. Without warning, Uruga pulls his cloak-beam dagger and lunges at King Maynulf, who shifts slightly the blade, only pressing his side. Before anyone can react, Uruga slings behind his fighters who are charging towards Hakon and King Maynulf. This is a damn shame, Hagen said. But I have to get my people inside those walls. You would. You are doing the same thing. This is leading, right? You look at the Valkyrie and nod. I'm sorry it's come to this. Joined banners or not, we were clansmen. The Valkyrie clenches his jaw. He looks over the armies, his eyes searching for a way out. Finding nothing, he looks back at you and inhales sharply and speaks with resolve. Then fight me like a war clansman, damn it! I'd hate to kill you easily. There's nothing more to say or time to say it. The two of you join your separate allies as the claymore of war pits you against each other. What a shame. I mean, and canary. Thank you so much. anything from here. Can't just sleep. Okay. Wait. Oh, this one here come. Kill the king. No, don't kill the king. I don't want to kill the king. That was not my intent. It was Ruga's plan. I didn't want to end it up like this, but I won't back down now. I'm sorry, Hakon. I wish things could be different. Oh, he dodged. All right, he still has that item. Oops. And now it works. The king's guards are legendary. Their lives are linked to the king's. Yes, and their mended charms will repair their armor. So we kill the king. Go for the arm. Sorry. It's gonna kill him, right? No. There was lots of room to walk. This is his guard. This is his guard. It's 15 dodge! 15%! Thank you. 15 means 150. This is bullcrap. It really is. He just can't get hit by me. it is. To the gate! Back to the gate! Killing strange. That Uga gave me. King Maynolf regains his footing and falls back toward Aberrant's walls as his forces rush past him and enter the fray. You wave the banner of Skulker and his clan surrounds you. To the gates! You shout over the clans of axes and hammers of shield. Clash. Your forces rush the gate of Aberrant's outer wall, dodging and blocking arrows as best they can. King Maynolf's army is well trained and immediately counters. Get inside those gates or finish! Troga shouts over the maddening roar of the Russian army. Oddleaf, I need you to take out those archers. Just take them out, huh? Her smirk slides, you know she will do it. Like a streak of light, Oddleaf manages to dart forward and dodge attacks while taking out enemy's archers in one few shots. Wait. Oh, it's Oddleaf, right. We don't have all of these for us. Maybe we'll take Gregory instead. For the king again, wait, swap him, because she can shoot. Yeah, but he is behind her initiative. Who goes first? Oh, it's so sorry. Starting to feel the Truga poison. Kill the king. I don't want to kill him. It's the 8-12 guy. If we get over here, we shoot him. It's 8-8. No. Should I destroy those? Just like this. Okay, he will get right here. Unless I don't have this. That heal hit checkpoint. using it. This. We need to kill them first. Let's keep going more. Both will die eventually. swing?
No, we don't.
Please say life a few more times. Yeah. I don't know if that's possible. Just keep in mind. Okay, so we could only need one space. That's good. Keep as far away from them as possible. Hopefully they will just fall with me around. I don't know if we need it. Oh! If you die of... or if... we need to finish it. Nice! Let me see here. Oh, he is still poison. This one's almost dead. No one's helping him. I don't really want it back. Reinforced gates of the second wall slam shut in front of me and archers above force you to retreat. A nasty affair taking over a kingdom. Who goes near you, rubbing this time on his missing hand. Wait, it was his left, right hand before. I wish I could have done more today, but I don't think he will much last longer inside his walls. You're too exhausted to worry about what he means, and so he walks away on other business. The closed gaze, stench of death, all of it threatens to turn your stomach and make you shake. Hey, I'm glad we survived through all of this, but... I know. You fought so hard to get here. For what? You made it to our brand, but not inside. You're not better off out here than in Bolesguard. It wasn't supposed to be like this. You were going to save everybody. I'm glad the Vow was able to make it inside. You had been separated from them. Audley's eyes look as empty as a fear as she slowly glances around. What now? Well, we can't stay out here. As much as I would like to sleep, we'll have to get behind those walls somehow. And then there's darkness. Juno said we have to hold out until they finish what they set out to do. But how are we supposed to know when they finish? She said to hold on until the darkness breaks. Until they are going to stop that darkness themselves? They're going to try. And we're going to try and stay alive until they do. Audley seems to take strength from the result. She takes a deep breath and her eyes focus on a man running towards you. Rook! The man yells and gets close. You recognize him as one of his scouts. It's Tolia, he whispers. They're dead. Every one of them. Hoofprints all over the place too. His words hit you and you scan the crowd. Unlike all the other fighters who are now resting, Canary and her horseborn are standing in armed ranks. They all look out of place, yet confident. You'll even think you see their leader smiling. You fear, quake, awe. Need to come to this. You killed her. Stop this, Eowyn. That's enough. You told me we would be in and out of here. This isn't in and out.
We hoped Valkyrie Lucy would be foolish enough to attack us.
You hoped I would let an escaped prisoner and a dead Valkyrie rope us without a fight?
We hoped there was some reason.
Reason? Yes. What was your reason for breaking the world?
You look at Juno and unsure of what to say.
Let's get what we came here for and leave. Remember the last words of her? The rascal. The dangers of truth are dwarfed by fear. Bra. Always hunting the truth of guilt. But you don't fear dying, do you, Ingva? My guess is you're fighting for the wrong cause. And you know nothing about Juno and Iron's cause. Iron gasps and looks straight. Who stands dropping the walls? Our cause broke council walls, but that doesn't make it wrong. You could have realized the importance of our war. You should have. And you too should have stopped your curiosities when the council warned you. You'd still never have each other.
Do you even see what you've become?
Juno's confidence vanishes at the question. You've never seen a Valkyrie steal something wrong.
And there are. Are you threatening to control his mind too?
If I were you, the large door of the Valkyrie's hall shakes from great impact then shatters.
Not you! Not now!
We will have our vengeance for your deceit! The floor and walls are now glowing, floating and breaking apart. Another Valkyrie enters the room. She looks concerned for the barely conscious Lucy mortified by dreaming. You lied to us. Your oath means nothing.
Wolf X Fragrance consuming cube is spitting more than spitting.
Is that Bellow's fan body?
Not just his body, I fear. Bellow's mind is not his own. Wolfrex looks at you and his eyes go wide before a cold hatred settles into his stare. We know you more, Trace, and her child. And I know you've lost your damn mind. I've seen things from the other side. The dread leaves warped and ruined by the true standoff. They lay waste to everything there near.
Wolfrex, I can... You don't do anything again. I'll pull you apart. I'll kill Eowyn and Ingvar. I'll pull out this arrow and...
No. The fear in her voice is infinite. Eowyn reacts to her by screaming, and the whole tower pulses with crackling energy, shaking violently. However, I'll help Eowyn and hold off Lucy. Cube Wolfrex, you're the only one who can. Wolfrex bows deeply and stands to his full height, brandishing his axes. He looks stronger than ever. Say, where are you, Ingvar? Stay. You step forward but feel the earth thicken around you for a moment, stopping you. Then it suddenly loses its grip. No, Zephyr. Now you'll do as I say. The Valka Zephyr looks shocked by Jane's control, but you waste no time in charging bulwark. You slam your head into him with tremendous force, sending him reeling across the room. Sense another mind within Bolvar.
Wait, and I don't know.
For all my people who fell through your schemes, you will pay. Are you all your people?
Zephyr is under my control, but I think Bellower is possessed by Bellower.
Bellower seems a little bit weird after all. Raids and thousands of others will be avenged.
Is losing control. Watch out for lightning.
I'm not dancing like that.
Right, Zephyr's wind. A lightning strike might free Boulder's mind.
Lightning strike might free Boulder's mind. So if I get over here... He will
come.
God damn it.
Thank you.
The roof of the tower is collapsing along with the walls. Aaron has clearly strained himself beyond his limits. The hulking form of Bulwark steps toward you, fire light glinting off the blades of the clawing trap. Aaron, drop the tower! Jim shouts. Protect Ivor if you can. Bulwark crawls but is dwarfed by the falling stones on Aaron's screen as he loses control.
Flash, threads unwind. Our intentions gone. Our fates laid bare. We are forced to change, pulled in new directions. For good or ill, we cannot know.
Banner Saga 2. We still haven't finished our journey, there's still one more. So I won't say goodbye, but we'll see, because we'll meet again. Well, thank you very much. Stay alive and see you soon.